I just believe very firmly that everyone should be able to live out their love story without the fear of discrimination.
And this was the night that President Obama was elected.
Mm-hmm.
And so everyone had just gotten the news, and there was this energy about the place. And with that, Stevie Wonder stands up, and one of the waiters says, "Mr. Wonder would like to make a speech." And so everyone in the restaurant
Wow.
is staring, and my heart was racing, and I just remember thinking, remember everything that you hear in this moment. And he stood up and he said, "This is for all the people who fought for this country and died so that we could vote. And this is for all of the people who lived their lives with love. This is for all the people who live their lives in hatred because they're only trying to be loved. This is for all of the believers and for the non-believers and for our future generations who will get to vote because of the people who have fought for this country. And most of all, this is for all the people here tonight whose main goal in life is to make this world and this country far better than it has ever been."
Another character that I had in mind, was a character I've seen a lot in my lifetime. A guy who's not interested in the same things that other guys are interested in, therefore he gets kicked around. And I've met so many fashion designers who grew up being absolutely ostracized and bullied and made to feel like they were nothing in school because they didn't play the sports that the other guys played and they didn't talk like the other guys. So I wanted to tell that story with this boy sitting in a locker room and he's reading fashion magazine. And the other guys come in and just start absolutely hassling him and trying to take it from him. And you can just see in his eyes that he just knows someday he's gonna be somewhere better.
I loved how they were being so experimental. They were taking so many risks. You look back to that time in pop music and in pop culture and in fashion, everybody seemed to be kind of bucking the system. Everybody kind of was like, well, we'll wear neon. You're gonna say we can't? We're gonna act how we want, love who we want, be who we want, say what we want. And so I was very inspired with this album. You'll hear like flickers and hints of 80s.
And it's kind of a love letter to the place you now call home, the Big Apple. And some are actually calling this song an equality anthem because of the following lyrics. Let me read them. Quote, "And you can want who you want, boys and boys and girls and girls." Tell us what inspired this song.
Well, the song is inspired by what I love about New York, which is just kind of there's a freedom to, and there's a celebration of being unique. Mm-hmm. You know, and that was something that I was very inspired by. And also I wrote the song, kind of following the, when gay marriage became legal in New York.
Mm-hmm.
And that was something that, you know, it's so many of my friends, had to be kind of scrutinized for who they were in love with, you know, from the time they came out. And I just, you know, I didn't want to make a big deal of it because I don't think it should be a big deal who you love,
mm-hmm.
you know?
GLAAD Stephen F. Kolzak Award is given to an openly LGBT media professional who has made a significant contribution in the fight for equality and acceptance. Tonight, I'm here to honor someone who through her words and through her actions proves that she is a force of nature. She tells the world that no one can judge us and no one can stop us. She is a woman of many talents. She is my friend, Ruby Rose. We know her and love her from her role as gender-fluid Stella on Orange is the New Black. But she really became a star back in 2007 as a DJ on MTV Australia. She's an actor, a model, and an incredible DJ. And in 2014, she wrote, produced, and starred in the short film Break Free, a tribute to gender nonconforming people. Ruby breaks down barriers and opens up opportunities for all people, but most importantly, young LGBT people all over the world.
Pride Month, and I think a lot about how it's very brave to be vulnerable about your feelings in any sense, in any situation, but it's even more brave to be honest about your feelings and who you love when you know that that might be met with adversity from society. This month and every month, I want to send out my love and respect to everybody who has been brave enough to be honest about how they feel, to live their lives as they are, as they feel they should be, as they identify. Yes. And this is a month where I think we need to celebrate how far we've come. We also need to acknowledge how far we still have left to go. Love and respect out to everybody who in their journey in their life hasn't yet felt comfortable enough to come out, and may you do that in your own time, and may we end up in a world where everyone can live and love equally and no one has to be afraid. Say how they feel.
One day I asked her, like, if you were ever to have a gay child, what would you do? And she was like, what do you mean, what would I do? They would just be gay. It was like such a simple answer. She was like, there's nothing to do. I would just love them and they would just be gay.
It really is a big deal to me. She votes against fair pay for women. She votes against the reauthorization of the Violence Against Women Act, which is just basically protecting us from domestic abuse and stalking. She thinks that if you're a gay couple, or even if you look like a gay couple, you should be allowed to be kicked out of a restaurant. It's really basic human rights, and it's right and wrong at this point. And I can't see another commercial and see her disguising these policies behind the words Tennessee Christian values. Those aren't Tennessee Christian values. I live in Tennessee. I am Christian. That's not what we stand for.
When it's like me, it's like dancers, cats, gay pride, people in country western boots.
I start riding a unicorn,
like just everything that makes me.
It's wonderful to be spending this particular evening with you because today is the first day of Pride Month. And you know, a lot of my songs are about love, and I just feel like, who you love, how you identify. You should be able to live your life the way you want to live your life, and you should have the same exact rights as everybody else. So I started this petition, and you can find the link on my Instagram. It's for the Equality Act, which basically just says that we want to send a message to our government that we believe that everybody should be treated fairly in this country. Sign it, it would really mean a lot to me, because I think we need to stick up for each other. We need to stand together.
She said, quote, I've had several music industry execs say, you're doing another music video about girls? I literally looked at them and was like, yeah, Taylor Swift sings about men in every single song and video, and no one complains that she's unoriginal. Taylor responded to a fan's post instead of Haley's comment, quote, we should applaud artists who are brave enough to tell their honest romantic narrative through their art. And the fact is that I've never encountered homophobia, and she has. It's her right to call out anyone who has double standards about gay versus straight love interest.
And this album was so much fun to write and to create because my main concept that I wanted to write about on this album were all the different types of love, all the different complexities and intricacies of this magical thing called love. And I think that love is so many things, you know? It's happiness, it's joy, it's madness, it's pain, it's longing. But I think most importantly right now, it's important that we all recognize that love is equality. I just feel like anyone who doesn't agree with me just needs to, like, calm down.
Control your urges to scream about all the people you hate. Your shade never made anybody less gay.
In this video, several points were made. So you voting for this video means that you want a world where we're all treated equally under the law. Regardless of who we love, regardless of how we identify, at the end of this video, there was a petition, and there still is a petition. Woo! For for the Equality Act, which basically just says we all deserve equal rights under the law. And I want to thank everyone who signed that petition because it now has 500,000 signatures, which is 5 times the amount that it would need to warrant a response from the White House.
There are so many of my loved ones and friends and fans who, you know, they're in the LGBTQ community and they have to go through life either being verbally, vocally judged and criticized, or wondering if the people around them are silently judging them, or wondering if the people around them are just tolerating the way that they are. And I think that's really unfair. And I just wanted to make it known to everyone around me and my loved ones and my fans and my friends and my colleagues, like, I don't just tolerate the way that you are. I celebrate the way that you are. And I want to support everyone having the same rights.
Hey guys, it's Taylor. I wanted to say happy Pride Month. We had a really good step forward recently with the Supreme Court ruling based on discrimination, based on sex. But we still have so far to go in terms of equality and protections for LGBTQ people and people in the trans community. The Equality Act has still not been passed, and that needs to happen. I got my census the other day, and there were 2 choices for gender. There was male and female. And that erasure was so upsetting to me, the erasure of transgender and non-binary people. And when you don't collect information on a group of people, that means that you have every excuse in the world not to support them. When you don't collect data on a community, that's a really, really brutal way of dismissing them. So obviously we all need to exercise our right to vote this year. We need to check out our absentee ballot policy in our states. And we need to make sure that we elect people who care about all communities. I love you guys so much, and I hope you have an amazing rest of Pride Month and continue fighting the good fight.
And mostly I want to say thank you to the fans for giving me a platform to make music and to be vocal about the things that I think are right and wrong. I just believe very firmly that everyone should be able to live out their love story without the fear of discrimination. And the way for that to happen is for us to continue to keep pushing governments to put protections in place for members of the LGBTQ community. And I promise to always advocate for that. And I'm just so grateful for this amazing award. Thank you so much.
Happy Pride Month. Thanks so much.
Subscribe to this channel.